throne, the Father of light and of men, chose to make himself known and show us the way back to him, speaking wisdom and truth into the hearts of peasants and kings. He began to unveil the word that would change the course of all things. With eyes wide open, all would see the word is alive, and he cuts like a sword through the darkness with a message of light to the hopeless and afraid, breathing life into all who believe. The word is alive, and the world in its glories will obey, but its truth it will not pass away. It remains yesterday and forever the same. Strokes on a page, eternity's secrets revealed and carried on from age to age. It speaks truth to us even still. But as the rain falls from heaven, feeds the earth before it returns, Lord, let your word fall on us. Bring forth the fruit you deserve. With eyes wide open, let us see the word is alive, and he cuts like a sword through the darkness with a message of light to the hopeless and afraid, breathing life into all who the word is alive, and the world in its glories will be, but its truth it will not pass away. It remains yesterday and forever the same. The word is alive.
The Bible was inscribed over a period of 2,000 years in times of war and in days of peace by kings, physicians, tax collectors, farmers, fishermen, singers, and shepherds. The marvel is that a library so perfectly cohesive could have been produced by such a diverse crowd over a period of time which staggers the imagination. Jesus is its grand subject, our good is design, and the glory of God is its end.
The word is alive, and he cuts like a sword through the darkness with a message of light to the whole. And afraid, breathing life to all who believe. The word is alive, and the world and its glories will fade, but its truth it will not pass away. It remains yesterday and forever.